Alright, my boy squad. Thank you guys for watching another vlog. But now, it's time for me to make an announcement. And it's not good news. Now that we've completed and presented to you all of the fun, positive, and happy stuff in our vlogs, it is time to make an announcement. An announcement that fills my heart with so much sadness. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the Mabuhay Squad. Enjoy! Malaya was a bird that I came across as just a chick earlier this year. A man was selling them in Quiapo, a famous marketplace here in Manila, for 400 pesos. The chicks were wild-caught and crammed into a little cage. I knew it wasn't wise to get a bird because, due to my work, I am always traveling and never home. But the connection I felt with the chick caused me to defy the reasoning. I wanted to save it. My plan was to nurse it to adulthood and then set it free. Over the next few months, RJ, my helper Ate Elsie, and I became the bird's foster parents. And so did you guys, the Mabuhay Squad, by tuning in every day to show your love and affection to the growing bird. You guys voted to call her Malaya, which in Filipino means free. Together we watched her grow, we fed her, we watched her take her first bite of solid food, we watched her take her first flight, and watched her first free roam outside without a leash or harness. She was an endearing bird, playful, sometimes mischievous, and full of life. When she was in trouble and hurt, she was strong enough to pull through. She was strong and confident. Malaya was the perfect mascot and ambassador of the entire channel, and stood for everything we promote in our vlogs. But while we were in Palau, we received a concerning message from Ate Elsie, informing us that Malaya suddenly seemed weak. We had agreed that if at any time Malaya was showing signs of illness or odd behavior, to take her to the vet. This is what she did. The vet couldn't identify what the problem was, but they suspected it was something she ate. She had been eating what she was always eating her whole life, the same superworms and fruits. So they resolved to put her on meds and send her back home. In less than 24 hours, Ate Elsie came home to find her dead in her cage. It was just the most tragic thing. RJ and I discussed how we would deal with the news regarding Malaya, and we finally came to the decision that we would announce the news after our line of major events, just so our concert and the Manila meet and greet would not be sad events for you Mabuhay Squad. We knew we had the obligation to you guys to keep everything happy, upbeat, and joyful as usual. We decided after all the events meeting you guys in person, we would finally break the news. Meanwhile, having to low-key deal with Malaya's death as well as the guilt and regret for not being there with her enough when she was alive, while keeping these vlogs upbeat and happy as usual, has been so hard. Perhaps some of you may have noticed after Palau, the energy of the vlogs has been a bit off. It showed also in our viewership numbers. It got to the point after Palau that vlogging every day became really difficult, and I had to summon the motivation to continue. For the first time in over 200 vlogs, working was less of a fulfilling activity and becoming a daily task. To be honest, the stress over the past few weeks has built up and thrown off our balance a bit. Even for RJ and I, we've never fought and argued so much than we have in the past few weeks. RJ has grown tired of these daily vlogs and always wanted me to stop, saying it didn't make business sense to do them. This was fair, as he felt the amount of work put into the vlogs versus the return didn't make business sense. I never agreed with him though, saying the intangible results were great and super worth it. But these days, I can see that it is now affecting my other work. My Aunt's Canada videos have become late periodically, and I let down our over 1 million subscribers each time. Our high demand parodies have been less frequent. I am super behind on business emails all the time. I haven't even had time to upload to my music channel, which I truly love and feel is my biggest passion. I've been low on sleep every night, and I stay up until 3 a.m. sometimes editing. We've turned down opportunities to visit places in order to upload our vlogs and accommodate editing time. I never thought I would last a week daily vlogging, but it has been your Mabuhay Squad love that has kept me going for 248 vlogs. I never missed an upload, not once. But the death of Malaya has toppled me, guys. With the death of our mascot, so too has my daily vlogging spirit. I need to recharge. My fear is that if I keep going, I will simply vlog myself to a complete crash. I started these daily vlogs in hopes to get closer to you guys, our viewers. And I have achieved that, and to commit to it for as long as it made sense. If I'm gonna be a content creator for years to come, I do have to make sure everything I do is sustainable. So Mabuhay Squad, I'm sorry to let you guys down, but I need time to take a break. During this break, I will try my best to deliver 2 to 3 vlogs a week and focus on getting back on track. I don't know how long or if it would be a permanent break, but I need it. We all need it. I don't see this as a period to the Pinoy Boy vlog serie. We just started. It's more of a comma, a breath mark. We have lots of great vlogs ahead, filmed and just waiting to be edited and uploaded. Your support and love mean a lot to us. We need it now more than ever. If you miss us, RJ and I are always daily posting on our IG accounts, so that's where you can find us. The links of those are in the description box. Otherwise, we hope you will continue to support and follow our videos here on the Pinoy Boy channel. We are Mabuhay Squad. Like Malaya, our love lives on forever. Love you guys so much, and I think of you every day. Mabuhay.
I believe you can soar. I see you running through that open door. I believe I can fly. Yes, I believe you can fly. I believe you can fly.